It's late at night. You're safe and warm in bed. You're watching TV. You're alone. You hear a strange noise. The cat, the dog, the wind. How do you know it's not a werewolf?
Back in 1987, Fox TV launched as the fourth network, fifth if you count Dumont, but that's a different video for a different time. And their signature show, their linchpin show, was Werewolf.
Lock your doors, turn off the lights, find a chair that's comfortable and safe. Prepare yourself for Werewolf. Next.
Early 80s saw a huge amount of werewolf fever. We had movies like The Howling, American Werewolf in London, even Company of Wolves, Wolfen, things like that. So Fox jumped on this train a few years too late in 1987, but they pumped a ton of money into this show. Even hiring Rick Baker to design the werewolf. The special effects were movie quality, the plots, not so much. Essentially, this show was about a college student, played by John J. York, named Eric Cord, whose college roommate is a werewolf and he murders him, and there's a sea cat. You know what? This promo says it way better than I can.
Eric Cord was just an ordinary college student until he was attacked by his roommate, a werewolf. Now he's running for his life, chased by a bounty hunter for the murder of his cursed friend. In pursuit himself of the evil werewolf Skorzeny, the source of his bloodline, a beast who must die to set Eric free. A race against time and the bloodlust that threatens to overwhelm him. Now, Werewolf, the legend continues.
Chuck Connors.
You're one of mine, aren't you?
Always terrifying, just as Chuck Connors.
Sit down.
Extra terrifying as an Italian werewolf sea captain with an eye patch.
But then kill yourself. That's the way a werewolf dies.
Now in this show, the rules are a little bit different. You're not always changing into a werewolf when it's a full moon. You pretty much change whenever it's convenient to the plot. But also, you know you're going to change because a pentagram-shaped scar on your hand starts to bleed. Stylistically, the show is basically The Fugitive meets The Incredible Hulk by way of Miami Vice with a little touch of horror in there. Despite an amazing ad campaign, which included an 800 number you could call and report werewolf sightings.
Werewolves.
In their human forms are nice people. A one man in Lancaster with a wife and kids had this special room built. And whenever he felt the feeling coming on, he had his wife lock him in the room. Mm. And she would hear the howling and the clawing. And then the next day she would open up the room and there he was, fine as can be. But inside, over a half inch of the wall was just ripped away.
So there are actually werewolves who are capable of caring.
Yeah, but mostly they're capable of nothing but killing and mutilation.
The show was ultimately a failure, and two of Fox's throwaway shows that were afterthoughts, America's Most Wanted and Married with Children, became their huge shows. So Werewolf was canceled after essentially one season. It developed a pretty big cult audience over the years, and at one point Shout Factory had printed and pressed DVD box sets of the entire series that sat in a warehouse to be destroyed because the music rights they thought they had, they didn't have. But luckily, people have uploaded the entire series of Werewolf to YouTube, so you can watch it there now. And side note, I did call the 800 number. It is not still active.
On all the unsuspecting, together,